After climbing and summiting Chaoyu just a couple of years ago, and then flying from the summit of Mont Blanc, I decided that maybe it wasn't such a crazy idea to attempt to climb and summit Everest and then fly off the top of that. That was about 6 months ago when I started thinking maybe it was a possibility, and then just a few months ago I decided to go for it.
So today is the 31st of March and it's the beginning of the Everest expedition. We left Kathmandu this morning at 7 o'clock and flew into Lukla. It was a 40 minute crazy flight and now we've arrived in this town, Lukla. It's quite bizarre because one of the first places I've come across is Starbucks.
There is no one who can save us now. We are lost in this craziness. There is no one here to show the way, but I protect us from this loneliness. I'm innocent, take my hand.
My suspension bridge.
Walk with me. Walk with me.
I'm in Namche Bazaar and just walking around all the shops, there's a huge selection of things, but I am very, very relieved that I didn't leave my knicker buying until I was here. Day 5 of our trek to base camp. It actually snowed this morning and it just shows how quick the weather can change. It was lovely and sunny yesterday. We woke up this morning to about that much snow. So we're walking today from Pengbuchet to Ferrochet. Ferrochet is about 4,200 metres. This is a really beautiful walk and just over my shoulder there, that's Amadablan. We've arrived in Ferrochet now. This is 4,200 metres. We're going to stay here tonight. I'm just hanging out with my friends the yet. We've climbed up to this area and all around us are these stacks of rocks and they're called chortens and each one represents a fallen climber. It's quite an eerie place really, but very beautiful. We've just reached a town called Lobachet, which is also known as Duvet Town, and here's why. Instead of vegetable patches, they grow duvets here in these nice little square walled areas. So let's see what Duvet Town has to offer. A couple of tea houses, a bakery, Alpine Inn restaurant. That is it. Some freshly harvested duvets over here.
When spoken to, I do what others do. Silence always wins, so silence everything. It will be alright, the morning light to silence.
I've come over this hill and I can most definitely see base camp. We've just got into the camp and this is going to be my home for the next 2 months. This tent here.
We're going to rest here for a few days and then we're going to start our acclimatisation, which is a process of going up and down really slowly, going a little bit higher each time. And then eventually, after a month or 5 weeks of that, we'll hopefully get the weather and go for the summit.
We could live.
puja ceremony, and the guy in orange is the llama, and he's come to bless all our climbing gear and all our kit and wishes a safe trip and safe return. It's quite cool. Climbing up to Camp 1. Woohoo, Camp 1! Nice weather at Camp 1!
Just brushing my teeth before we leave to go to Camp 2. Important to have fresh breath.
Yeah, we rested yesterday and today we're going to hike up to the bottom of the Lhotse face. So just go for a couple of hours, get used to the acclimatisation. It's a really nice camp here because there's rocks and things that, I don't know, it doesn't feel quite so exposed as Camp 1. And we've got a dining tent as well, which is really nice. Camp 2 is about 6,400 metres. Climbing up to Camp 3 now, which is 1,000 metres vertical hike gain, so it takes us at about 7,400. We've been going for about an hour and we've not really climbed that much. It's really hot, I'm really tired, but I feel like I've got it in me and it's really, really beautiful, so I'm enjoying the walk. I arrived at Camp 3. I'm so tired. We're coming back down now from two nights at Camp 3, back to Camp 2 and then back down to base camp. We're doing some abseiling down the Lhotse face. It's quite hairy. Today is the 8th of May 2011. It's Sunday morning. We got up at 2 o'clock this morning and we're about an hour into the walk up the Cumber Ice Wall. We've started our summit push. It's a really dark night, but I guess this light will come up in about an hour or two. I'm feeling quite good so far. A little bit nervous, a bit excited. But yeah, here we go. We made it to Camp 1 about 20 minutes ago, and now we're on our way to Camp 2, me and Stu. There's Camp 1 in the distance. Here's a massive crevasse. Here's Squash, tired, snotty nose. Looking forward to a cup of tea and eating. This is me and Stu at Camp 2. We're exhausted, having walked up from base camp, and we're just eating some cold truffle pudding. And we'll mostly be doing this for the rest of the day. We're now in Camp 3. It's only taken me 7.5 hours to get here, which is almost an hour longer than the last time it took me. It's just gone 5 o'clock in the morning and we're leaving Camp 3 to go to Camp 4. got in the tent at Camp 4. Took me 7 hours and 11 minutes to get here. Amazing day. Really hard. So happy to be here. My plan is to leave here at 8 or 9 o'clock tonight to go for the summit.
It's 8:30 on the 11th of May and we're leaving to go for the summit of Mount Everest. This is me and this is Stu.
Yeah.
And this is the summit. And the stars. It's a nice night. Fingers crossed that it stays that way.
The weather was so bad that I only managed to turn the camera on for a few seconds on the summit. I didn't manage to film anything on the way up, nothing on the way down. It's taken me ages to get down. Haven't drank anything for about 12 hours, haven't eaten anything. All my water bottles are frozen solid. My nose is looking pretty horrendous. My face is probably quite swollen. I didn't get to fly off Everest, but one out of two isn't bad. I got to the summit. Today is Friday, the 13th of May. It's the day after we summited Mount Everest. I'm feeling a lot better today. This morning I tried to take off from the South Col on my paraglider. The wind was too strong. I gave it my best shot and I couldn't take off. Yesterday, at 8:30 in the morning, I summited Mount Everest and I have got 3 messages for the world. One, you've got to try because you never know what you might achieve. Two, take your love and passion wherever you go. And three, if your knickers are right, everything goes right. And just to prove that to you, I'm going to show you the knickers that I was wearing yesterday.